with wrestling. Sean Lathan, the professional. Jeff Simmons, whatever he does for a living.
What do you mean, what I entertain you, Lathrop, and I do a dang good job at it.
No, go get out of here, all right? You're one of the worst things I've worked with.
Hey.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please welcome your NWO Intern Commissioner, Oscar Hoskey.
And we have not seen Hoskey here at the NWO for a long, long while. Coming back as the Interim Commissioner.
Yeah, I don't really know what to say about this guy, Lathrop.
He's had some problems in the past with Frost.
Thank you very much. Please give a round of applause for Noah. You're doing a great job.
Oh, jeez.
Definitely enough appreciation.
Well,
I want to thank everybody. I am acting commissioner for this episode. I want to thank everybody for coming out. But I came out here with a purpose. We need a little bit of a shake-up, and the best way to shake it up, I'm going to give you guys a wild card tag team match. But not just a two, we're going to make it a triple threat, where the winner gets a tag team title shot at our inaugural debut in Battle Creek. So, with that being in mind, let me get Carter started. Let me welcome out first, coming out to the ring from Miami, Florida, weighing 220 pounds, welcome Rob Frost!
Get out there!
What?
You're in tag team action! Congrats!
Sometimes, Lathrop, sometimes.
Is this your theme?
Here we go!
Whoa, wait.
I'm back again!
Who is that guy?
That's you! But you're...
all find out!
How are you doing this?
I don't know.
But in all seriousness, Jeff, this is the real Rob Frost.
His tag team partner from South Warren, Michigan, weighing in at 375 pounds. Please welcome your champion this year, Victor Cross.
Rob Frost, to put a little perspective of him, because everyone knows who Victor Cross is, the television champion is. Rob Frost, on the other hand, is a 10-year veteran of the business, a former student of Briar Wellington, and has fought the names like Rick Martel and Justin Main. A man who's been on the block and rode that block for a while.
There you are again, talking about your invisible friends, Lathrop.
You're right here, for one. Or over there. We're still trying to figure out. I'm just trying to give you a little background on who this person is, because we have not seen Rob Frost in a long, long time.
Okay, that's enough about Rob Frost. Let's talk about Trick or Slam a little bit here, and let's talk about the date that this man, the Super Booty, Victor Cross, has with Jacob Mercury.
And their opponents, coming in at 350 from Battle Creek, Michigan, please welcome Loco and DJ.
Loco and DJ have went to war with the current champion, Salt and Pepper, and actually have a pinfall victory over the current tag team champions. And as we heard from our interim commissioner, the winner of this match will get a tag team title shot at Battle Creek. Where are these individuals from?
Battle Creek, exactly. And they're gonna win the titles in their hometown, Sean Lathrop. I've been saying this all along ever since these two debuted here. These two are the future of tag team wrestling in the Michigan Wrestling Organization.
And their opponent, first coming out from St. Clair, Michigan, weighing 280 pounds, this here is Ricky Cartier.
I know Hoskey hasn't been here for a while, but it's now Rick Cartier, old school Rick Cartier. But the current Great Lakes champion in this match, the television champion is in this match, a team that has won the battle with Salt Pepper. This is all around really a championship caliber match. This could main event any other show.
For one time, I'm going to agree with you on that, Lathrop. But here's the question. The question is how are Mr. Cartier and Mr. Freytown going to get along?
Wait, I mean Mr. Freytown.
And his partner, he's coming in at a slim trim, 205 3/4 pounds from Minneapolis, Minnesota. He's the Flatliner, Scotty Freytown.
How did you know, Scotty? Freytown was going to be Rick Cardia's tag team partner?
Well, because I got sources, Lathrop. I pay good money for these sources. Real good money.
That's crazy. I mean, with Scotty Freytown and Rick Cardia, let's focus more on that, not necessarily your sources or whatnot. Scotty Freytown and Rick Cardia as a tag team, they're going to be going at it at Trick or Slam. After that, they can't even go on to face the tag team champ.
Well, I mean, they have a chance now. They have a chance to go to Battle Creek as the number one contenders. The thing is, how are they going to coexist? That is the question.
Well, there is a large amount of mutual respect between these two individuals.
Yeah, and it makes me sick.
Freytown has said he is super excited to battle Rick Cardia at Trick or Slam.
I know!
As he feels these two men, him and himself, against Rick Cardia, taking the house down and provide something that not many people have seen before. But as a team, that's a lot of different stories.
Okay, well, here's what I'm going to say, Lathrop. DJ Edwards and Loco have been teaming together, okay?
Absolutely.
So, and they have a victory over the tag team champions. Now, Freytown and Cartier, we don't know how that's going to turn out, and that's a combustible element waiting to happen. You know it is because of Trick or Slam.
Exactly.
And I know nothing about this Rob Frost guy and the television champion, who is definitely worried about his television championship. So if you ask me, the advantage goes to DJ Edwards and Loco.
But getting off that, we are already seeing the heated exchange between Rick Cardia and Scotty Freytown in the middle of the ring. But Scotty is now saying he's going to be starting this match off.
Exactly, and the bell hasn't even rang yet, Lathrop. These two want to tear each other apart.
Getting away from these two as well, I am going to be agreeing with you. I believe Loco and Edwards has the strongest momentum winning this match and perhaps facing the tag team champions at Battle Creek. But I do want to point out that Mr. Rob Frost and Victor Cross could easily put in an interesting tandem. You have the surprise factor out of Rob Frost, and you have the fact that Victor Cross, when teaming with A Wicked, has a pinfall victory over the current No More Contenders, the Sinister Prophets.
That is true. But speaking of surprise factor, did you see how fast Rob Frost left and jumped out of the ring there?
As you already see him putting in a front face chin lock. DJ Edwards, very cocky individual, him and Loco.
There's nothing wrong with being cocky if you can back it up in the ring, Sean Lathrop, and that's what Loco and DJ Edwards do. Oh. Yeah, it looked a little below the belt there, Lathrop.
But Eric Cherry was in position and saw that was, oh my goodness, that was a loud tag. That sounded more like a knife-edge chop than a tag.
Now, I'm not a fan of, I didn't mean to cut you off there, like, actually I did, I always do, but I'm not a fan of Rick Cartier by any means, but you know, he has had an attitude as of late that I have never seen from Rick Cartier. I just can't explain it.
Not since the days of him and Fat Tony were a team here at MWO has Rick Cardia really acted as such. Scotty Freytown has really, really made things annoying for him, as he's now smacking Scotty Freytown to get back in the match.
Well, all's fair in love and war there.
Oh. And if anyone's going to feel bad about it, it's DJ Edwards having to deal with an aggravated Scotty Freytown and an aggravated Rick Cardia.
Oh, now, here we go again, Sean Lathrop. Every time we're out here, Scotty Freytown with these... And now, look at what he's doing to Eric Cherry.
It's coming Wedgie City here at MWO. Everyone gets one. Everyone puts out right next door.
I'm glad you think this is amusing. It's not even remotely funny, Lathrop.
And it's Scotty Freytown showing his strength, almost hitting the top of the ceiling. Big suplex there on the Loco. But you were able to get in there and stop the count. Good job.
Yeah.
Oh. It was a lighter tag this time, though.
You know, what it seems like is these two macho men are trying to outdo each other right now. Cartier, the champion, and Freytown, you know.
Which can only spoil more and more trouble like that for Loco and Edwards.
I disagree. They just don't have the tag team continuity that Loco and Edwards have.
It's true, but they're the ones keeping the beat down. Oh, here comes another pin. One.
Oh, see right there. There's that tag team continuity that I was talking about.
Yeah, this would be hard from the win, but you know they're going to take a huge beat down from Freightown and Cardi just because of how they're acting.
Oh,
almost smacking him across the face with that tag.
There was no almost about it, Lathrop. There was a blatant smack to the face.
That's what I'm more saying. Another cover here.
Oh, and right there.
Loco was able to get it. But
good
Edwards
save by their Edwards.
Yes.
Oh, oh,
there goes
oh.
Bob Frost and DJ Edwards to the outside. Back suplex. Another pin.
Oh.
You'd almost say that Rick Carty and Scotty Freighton are taking their frustrations out on each other by doing so to Loco.
What?
Oh! Hard, hard landing there. Kind of a powerbomb like maneuver.
Come on, boss!
Oh! Oh, cannonball! How great does Scotty Freighton look? Since he's came here, he's already lost about 40 pounds. And it really increased his cardio here in MWO.
Oh, I thought you were talking about that ridiculous outfit, Lathrop.
Oh, no. It's like a mix between maybe an ice cream sundae and the Ultimate Warrior or something. I'm not.
I don't know what it is, but he definitely got dressed in the dark again. I've been telling him to turn the light on when he gets dressed, but he just doesn't.
Another tag there, hard tag from Rick Cartier.
Yeah, I see if you get a double. Come on. Can you work with someone? Come on.
Seeing if the other guys can work together.
Well, that's an illegal maneuver, Sean Lathrop. You can't double team a guy like that.
Oh. Air Cherry's hand was nearly there. We were about to have, did you say number one contenders?
Yeah.
I can do something.
These two are just focusing so much on outdoing each other.
It's true.
Look at this. I'm
feeling more and more bad.
Loco almost got the tag because they were arguing over him. He almost did.
It was close. Of course, it's only a matter of time until this could end in either man's favor.
Oh, look out, big tag here.
The first time Victor Cross has entered this match or any member of that team.
Oh, wow. Yeah, he doesn't want to match power with the super booty. That's for sure.
Oh, no, absolutely not. Scotty Freightown trying to hit the big headlock on the big man, the big booty of Victor Cross.
Oh, there's a blind tag there, Sean. Look out. Oh!
Television champion, Great Lakes champion, both in the ring. But Cardi now focused on Scotty Freightown.
See, these guys aren't worried about the match. They're worried about outdoing each other. So, look out!
It's finally come to blows.
Here we go. We got a Pier 6 brawl here.
You'd think someone would be counted out by now.
You knew it was going to come to this. And look at the super booty just standing there looking at it.
Well, I don't blame him.
I don't either.
Bye.
Oh, Cartier is...
Is the legal man right
now. Whoa! Oh, he just brought Edwards in the hard way.
And I guess the referees decided to make Edwards the legal man now. It's a strange call by referee Eric Cherry, but I'd rather have a clear winner versus these two men going off to the back and fighting.
That could do it.
Two. And it's not enough as Rob Frost could not take care of DJ Edwards right there.
Nice.
And here comes Loco coming in the match. The teamwork of DJ Edwards and Loco as you were saying, as I believe with you, it will be too much for any other team to really beat in this.
Oh, absolutely. That's why they pinned our current tag team champion, Sean Lathrop. You know, they look out here. What? Oh, wow.
Big elbow.
Vicious.
Followed up with a chop.
Oh, look at that.
Interesting maneuver there, tagging in his partner while doing the diving clothesline. Frost is in trouble. Edwards knocking Frost.
Wait a minute here.
Apron.
What's he going for here?
Swanton bomb off the top rope.
That's got to do it. Yes. Yeah. Sean Lathrop, I've been telling you all along, and I am never wrong. You know, you're learning this. You're slowly learning this, like you slowly learn everything. But those two men right there now have a shot at the NWO Tag Team Championship on November the 6th in Battle Creek, in their hometown.
I'm going to break this down in numerous ways. One, we both said the same thing. We both said Loco and Edwards were the favorites, as these two were the actual team with pinfall victories of the current champs. Two, who they faced that day is still to be determined between Salt and Peppa and the Sinister Profits. And three, I can't believe you lost that match. You could have kicked out, but you lost that match.
What do you mean I lost?
Loco pinned you right there.
I did not lose that match.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next contest is scheduled for one fall.
No, he just must have just woke up from his nap in his trailer.
And his opponent.
Maybe he does remember. He's praying, Lathrop.
He's T-bowing. He's Colin Kaepernicking.
He hails from a plus of 5 location, weighing in at a 285 pounds, codename Omega!
Codename Omega now taking Bandrizzi's hat there.
I don't know if I'd be touching that hat, Lathrop. You don't know where that's been.
Touching it, I mean.
Well, yeah, I did.
He knew not to touch it.
I wouldn't want the stick on there, too. Yeah, no.
But Conan Omega, as we see, no Colonel Lawdog, no Dr. AJ. No one is going to be here to try and control Omega if he gets out of hand. Of course, with that only screams to me that this could be even more dangerous for Van Grizzly than it could have been in the first place.
Exactly. He's at a distinct disadvantage in this match. Not that he already wasn't, but
I don't think the only advantage he had is his Law Dog or AJ right here. He would have had a chance of taking on a less controlled assassin in Cordell Omega. Van, the one thing he's always got is the crowd behind him.
Yeah, unfortunately, these people are fans of the Duck Dynasty franchise, which Bam's relatives are part of.
And we're already seeing the power game of Codename Omega, the strength this man can bring to the table.
Well, I'll tell you what, Lathrop, if this turns into a speed game, I'm not going to say this much, but it favors Bam Grizzly. If it turns into a ground-and-pound power style, a ground-and-pound power style, codename Omega definitely has the advantage.
Getting really close to us here at the commentation station.
Three!
There comes Bam Grizzly!
Oh, he caught him. He caught him, Lathrop.
Trying to stay away from this action. And spine burst into the ring post. Codename Omega.
Seven!
Now flamming him down onto the ring apron.
Wow. That back might be fractured.
But that's not going to stop Bam Grizzly. One. See, that's what I'm talking about. One count there. Despite the damage he just took, Bam Grizzly is not going to let up. Oh! Another strike, just bouncing Bam around. There's much hot strength Cody Omega has. I want to bring this up. Omega does not exactly have a good win-loss record here at MWO compared to what Bam Grizzly has done in this company. He's went toe-to-toe with the Great Lakes champion, even made it to the finals at Slam-a-thon. But Cody Omega, I honestly don't know when his last victory was.
Well, he's been in a little bit of a slump, but everybody goes through a slump, Sean Lathrop. Your life's full of them.
But I think the big thing with Cody Omega is that you may win the match. This is possibly true when you take on a guy like him. But you may not be able to breathe for the next month or two.
Exactly.
That's the danger of Codename Omega. Bam still trying to strike the bigger frame of Omega, but it's getting too much now for him.
Oh, wow.
Boot to the face, right into the beard, it looked like, of Bam Grizzly.
Well, that beard needs trimming anyways, Lathrop.
Now he's grabbing the beard down, pulling.
Well, there, he's going to trim the beard for him, see? Codename Omega's doing him a favor.
This crowd still cheering, still hoping for Bam Grizzly.
Oh, wow.
You call that more of a beard toss, not really a hip toss. So it seems to be the focus of his offense is right in the facial region of those long curly cues.
I wouldn't know, Lathrop. I don't grow hair on my face.
Oh! Thumb to the eye, stopping the band.
What are you talking about, thumb to the eye?
Whoa! What's Jessica doing here?
I don't know. Why are you complaining about it?
It's out of character. That's. They're going two. Bam Grizzly able to kick out. But like I said, it's very out of character for Jessica to be here. She looks almost smitten with Bam Grizzly. Putting him now into a reverse dragon.
Wow. What a submission hold here. I've never seen this before from Codename Omega.
The Codename Omega master, so many submissions, so many maneuvers. Getting right back in the reverse dragon. And trying to lift him over. Bam! Able to counter. Bam! 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 Codename Omega just staggering though. Big back elbow. Bounced off the ropes. Double accidental. Codename Omega still standing. Cross the face, just make him stagger once again. Big running dropkick taken down to Codename. Another pin.
It's going to take a lot more than that, Sean Lathrop.
It will.
We're talking about Codename Omega here.
And there's Jessica. Tossing Bam Grizzly once again. Bam seems to fall for it.
Bam is the luckiest man in the world.
Double arm choke slam. Two. Three.
Here is your winner, Codename Omega!
And what a emotions. Come to the ring. As you saw in the last episode, Bam Grizzly stood toe with Steels and Cody Lee to try to get some sort of tactic and defense against Posse.
There's nothing wrong. What is Tanner arguing with?
Now wait a minute.
Cody Lee and the Steels have no business out here.
Well, what do you expect? It was a 4-on-1, and they have made a friendship with Bam Grizzly. And the lines are being crossed right
now. Wow. Oh, here we go. Here we go, Lathrop.
Danny Tanner, Eric Chandler, and Orville Houston all here to try and stop this.
This is what we're going to see at Trekker Slam.
Right in top of each other. Andrew Steele and Morpheus Rexley Jackson partners when they eliminated Stuntman Mike from his company. And Andrew Steele, the whole Steele brothers going after Codename Omega. And we know the history between these two individuals.
Wow.
Everything is just going crazy and absolutely bombastic. And the Steels. Double spear taking down Codename Omega. Codename Omega has been left high and dry by the rest of Positive Promotions.
Wow. I can't believe what I'm witnessing, Lathrop.
This almost reminds me of the old days where Cody Leader ran crew with Awesome Alliance. In fact, it was back then. It was Andrew Steele and Cody Leader, a part of the Awesome Alliance.
Well, they're raising their hands right now, Lathrop. But the question is, are they going to be raising their hands at Trekker Slam?
You know, I'm going to claim it right here. I don't know how people are going to react, but I'm going to say AA 2.0, they could easily beat PP at TRS. See what I'm doing there? I'm using the letters.
Yeah, that's real, real cute, Lathrop.
We still have a lot more to go.
Exactly, so get these stooges out of here.
As we heard in the previous episode, Simon Page and Skulls will be going one-on-one. Not many times have we seen Page be willing to get in the ring. He usually allows Blackwell to take care of his dirty work, and I don't blame him when you got Blackwell behind you. But this could be a very interesting contest.
What are you talking about? He's a fighting man. He's not backing down.
Simon says you lose. Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall. Interesting birth. From Sin City, weighing in at 165 pounds, he is the self-proclaimed greatest mind in all of sports entertainment.
Sean Lathrop, Trekker Slam, there is a rest in peace match between Skulls against Simon Page and Blackwell. Well, Simon Page might not let Skulls get the Trekker Slam.
I just did an open challenge to the resident bonehead of the MWO. never got an answer to this open challenge.
Like,
so, Chair, why don't you just go ahead and declare me the winner, and we'll just go home, and maybe we'll show up at Trekker Slam, maybe not,
yeah.
Who cares?
Now raise his hand, Cherry.
Well, we're already hearing the music.
Wait a minute.
Simon Page is already looking startled.
Wait a minute.
Come on, Paul!
Ladies and gentlemen, weighing in at 233 pounds, he is the ruler of parts unknown. This is Skulls.
Sean Lathrop, you're telling me that Skulls has the courage to get in the ring with Simon Page before Tricker Slam?
I'm surprised Eric Cherry's in the ring with Skulls before Tricker Slam. But you just look in the face of Simon Page, that is a face of absolute disbelief. He did not expect Skulls to come, but it's not like Skulls has a cell phone to call him back.
Watch your back, Skulls.
And you can even see Blackwell isn't even here. Simon Page was that confident that Skulls was not going to show.
Bring it.
Watch your back.
Oh. And he's already in.
Simon already gouging the eyes of Skulls. Oh. I don't know what Simon Page thinks he's going to do in this one. Oh, yeah. Big hard headbutt, the hardest head in this company. And a boot cross.
That's an illegal choke there, Sean Lathrop.
But we know Skulls' tactics. He is a man that loves to work on the trach and loves to work on the throat of his opponents.
He's also a man that likes to bend the rules a little bit, too.
The Skulls is already calling for it to be over, waiting for Simon to stand. Might be better for him to just get out of here as soon as possible. But here goes Michael Reaver. That will be the disqualification in favor of Skulls for victory.
Here is your winner by disqualification, Skulls.
And now here comes Blackwell. We saw in the last episode, Michael Reaver and Skulls went toe-to-toe. We thought Reaver's knee was completely done. But clearly, not only is his knee not done, he's not done with Skulls or Simon or Black. I don't even know how to react to this.
Yeah, you don't. Let me do the talking. What's going to happen is Skulls is going to get dismantled before Tricker Slam. I told you.
Skulls is fighting back. Grabbing Reaver by the throat. But Blackwell. Oh, no.
Wow.
Okay, what's the out of it? Okay, no. Skulls is still fighting hard against these three. And now they are hightailing out of here. Skulls going into handicap action against both Simon Page and Blackwell. And as you say, a rest in peace match at Tricker Slam, a specialty of Skulls.
I think he's bitten off a little more than he can chew this time, Lathrop.
Yeah, Simon's in a really rough shape.
That's not who I'm talking about.
And he's pointing at Reaver.
I'm talking about the bonehead in the ring.
Reaver is not taking his eyes off Skulls, and either is Skulls towards Reaver. It seems like the... I'm not sure what Simon's going to be causing this group he's got here of Michael Reaver and Blackwell, but it is definitely going to be a scary group for Skulls to try and take down. Of course, with that match, we are going into our main event of the evening. Six-man tag team action. Mike Goodman, PI, Stitches McVeigh, Jack Tarrant against the tag team champions of Jack Price and Apocalypse and the heavyweight champion of John Campbell.
Well, huge, huge implications for Tricker Slam with the championship matches, Sean Lathrop, and the big six-man tag.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is your main event of the evening. It's scheduled for one fall, and it is a six-man tag team match. Introducing first, he hails from the Goodman Detective Agency, weighing in at 200 pounds, Mike Goodman, P.I.
As I was saying, here is stuntman
Mike Goodman, P.I., exactly. One of the newest superstars here in the Michigan Wrestling Organization.
The man, Laura Phoenix, retired at Summer Smash.
I don't know who you're talking about.
Laura Phoenix.
And his partners.
I know you have a crush on Larry, but it's okay.
Ha 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 ha
Yeah, you're one to talk, Four Eyes.
Can you stop insulting the crowd?
They hail from exit 13, weighing at a total combined weight of 500 pounds, Jack Terran and Stitches McVeigh, the Sinister Prophets.
Sean Lathrop. In the tag team division here in the Michigan Wrestling Organization, there has been one team on a major roll lately, and they will win gold at Trick or Slam, in this guy's opinion, and that is the Sinister Prophets.
Come on, come on, get with it, get with it now.
I don't know how you find this amusing.
They hail from your favorite recipe book, weighing in at 2 tablespoons of greatness, Apocalypse and Jack Price, Salt and Pepper.
Push it.
I'm not about to push anything unless it's you off that chair again.
That was terrible in the last episode. You're so much of a fun student. What's up, little man? How's it going?
Yeah.
Good? High five? All right.
Oh, you got a friend, Lathrop.
Hey, the fans love me. I don't know what you're doing here. Oh, oh! He got him! He got him! Ah! Oh.
This is the problem. They cater to the fans.
Oh! Oh, this is fun, isn't it?
No, it's not.
Your heavyweight champion. The dancing. This is going to be a fun night for me, probably not you, and the rest of the audience.
Probably not me. There's no doubt it's not me. These guys need to focus on the task at hand. You're over here celebrating, throwing candy in the ring. You know, you got three determined individuals that could very well be champions after Trick or Slam, Sean Lathrop.
This is what I kind of like when we have matches like this. It's a battle of the number one contenders, and it's a battle of the champions. It's the best view of what the top parts of each division taking each other on, as well as seeing how these men that normally don't face each other, how they could coexist. It's one of my favorite aspects of pro wrestling.
It's also going to show that how much of a disgrace our current champions are right now.
Well, that just seems to be uncalled for. And Jack's saying it's straight true.
See, these guys right here, Mike Goodman, P.I., and the Sinister Prophets, they are on the same page. You can tell.
Here we go. Look at all this gold here. Look at all that gold. Oh, Salt and Pepper.
Oh, don't pretend like you're a champion. You've never been the champion of anything, Lathrop.
Just hold it in place for this team.
Yeah.
Hey!
Oh! Hey!
Oh! Hey!
I don't know how referee Orville Hughes is allowing this.
The match has not started yet, so he has no control yet.
It's go time!
Oh!
trifecta, a golden version of sexual vest taking time.
Jump, this is ridiculous.
I know you don't have any kind of love for the finer culture of hip-hoppity.
It looks bad.
No, I have love for the finer culture of wrestling. That's what this is, Sean Lathrop. A wrestling match.
You would have hate the 80s of Cindy Lee Roper and...
Get that disgusting bucket away from me, Sean Lathrop. I don't know where that's been.
And Apocalypse already showing the power game against Stitches McVay. Of course, we have seen the team of Salt and Pepper, especially Apocalypse, be played so much by Taryn and McVay's mind games. Stitches already being thrown around.
But the tag team continuity of Salt and Pepper just hasn't been there lately, Sean Lathrop. You gotta admit that.
No, ever since... Well, that went great. Ever since their loss to Drogo and DJ Edwards, it has been a little bit of a rougher road for Salt and Pepper. Right, telling him to do it one more time.
Is Jack eating candy while he's sitting on the tag rope? Is that what's going on?
Do you not like candy? I mean, do you hate everything about life?
I don't hate life.
Stitch is going for one more time. Stitch is... Apocalypse! Apocalypse is in rough pain right now. He is in pain. Stitches McVay. Mondo actually hurt him really bad. I am not sure if he can continue this match right now.
He's not. Not at all. Not even remotely funny. Like you, Lathrop.
Just look at the height difference between these two. It's not going to play well for Stitches. Stitches, what is Stitches McVay doing? He's grabbing a chair! Stitches saying he is not going to hit Apocalypse.
What? Wait a minute, what is... What? Okay.
Mike Goodman, PI, is completely dumbfounded by this.
What? This is a wrestling match. I'm going to say that again, Lathrop.
These are your future tag team champions, according to you. I don't understand what Stitches McVay is trying to do either.
Wow, look at him overpowering, Lathrop. Did you know Stitch has had that strength?
I don't think he's getting overpowered. Apocalypse starting to groove and tubing on Stitches McVay. Over Houston getting a good idea, getting that chair out of the ring. Stitches brought in. Oh my goodness.
Oh, I thought that hurt your hand a little bit.
Not so much.
Yeah, I'm surprised Apocalypse is able to get back into this after how much damage Stitches McVay did with those three clotheslines to him.
Yeah.
And here comes the power game, though. Jack Taryn of the Sinister Profits.
Yeah, and we remember a slamming Saturday night when these two men were in the ring. Who got the victory, Sean Lathrop? Jack Taryn.
Jack Taryn bouncing off the ropes. This man is making Apocalypse push. So Apocalypse getting the elbow back to face. The fans always in love with what John Campbell brings to him. But what about what Jack Price is bringing to Jack Taryn? Jack coming back.
Oh.
We got two Jacks and a super. Oh, no. Taryn blocking.
Caught him.
Taryn's biting out of it. Price trying to clamp something. Oh. Ducking the clothesline. Price.
Oh, wow.
Big power slam there. Wow. Scoop slam by Jack Rutherford.
Lathrop, I did not know he had that strength.
We've seen this kind of strength out of him against men like Skulls, against ex-convict, against Zero Briggs. He's a shot shot right now. But how about this for you? The TBE. TTE. Not, it's ready. I can't get the initials right.
Yeah, whatever. Not enough to put Jack Taryn away, though.
Wait, well, John Campbell said he could do it.
John Campbell needs help getting over the rope. There's a surprise.
Oh! And Campbell with his own tribute to Eddie. One, two counts there. Apocalypse!
Oh, come on!
He's gonna kill everyone!
For the love of God, Lathrop, come on! Oh, no. No, no, no. No, no.
Oh, my goodness. Hold on!
Oh!
Oh! Oh. Wasn't able to get over, but get a leg drop. One, two. Coming off more like a leg drop from Apocalypse. I'm just shocked that he was able to try something like that on Jack Taryn. And big headbutt.
Oh.
Headbutt. Jack Taryn. When Ira stepped into the ropes, this ring is about to break, considering how much humanity is in here.
Oh, wow.
Big body slam. Box flash from John Campbell. Yeah! And there goes the top row!
Whoa!
We're getting dangerous!
Whoa!
We're getting dangerous now!
Oh! That's what I'm talking about. The amount of humanity, the amount of power that's in this ring, and the top row just broke off!
I would never cheat!
Yeah, you would!
But we still have a big match still to go on our hands.
Well, I think Apocalypse broke the top rope. There was no way around it, Lathrop. And he's about to break it again. Look at this guy.
Bruce, if you really think about it, big double chop there with the top rope being taken out.
Let me ask you a question, Lathrop. When's the last time you saw an elephant fly? Never.
As I was saying, with the top rope down, this actually could play in the hands of Mike Goodman and the Sinister Profits, because it takes away a lot of the aerial offense from Jack Price.
Absolutely.
Oh. Big clothesline, dropping the knees to try and make him stutter, but he couldn't do it.
Oh,
again.
Oh.
Now goes Apocalypse.
Took the big man off of his feet, Lathrop.
It took
a while. There's the tag.
Now, Mike Goodman, double leg drop to the lower region, perhaps the stomachal region of Apocalypse. They're grabbing him by the beard.
Mike Goodman PI's like a surgeon. He's going to slowly dissect Apocalypse.
He's more like a detective. Trying to Irish rip him to the ring pose, I guess you would call it now. Oh, missing it. I'm not even sure if we should call it a top rope or a middle rope now. Here comes.
Well, the rope, nonetheless.
Here comes Stuntman Mike hitting those shoulders.
Yeah, he's not Stuntman Mike. Lathrop, I thought you would have learned this by now.
I'm sorry, I'm terrible at learning. And Mike Goodman able to knock himself down as well as Apocalypse. Go for the pin. Two. Hooking the inside leg. And using some of your words, outside leg might have been able to finish it for him.
Exactly.
The Jack Price was able to tag in Apocalypse, and we have stitches of Jack Price now with his illegal individuals in this matchup. Back kick, knee to the face. Followed up with a Russian leg sweep. And what is, it's like a head scissors here. Very jiu-jitsu-esque maneuver from Jack West, but he's got to make sure his shoulders do not lay on the mat. This could be a pivot maneuver for him at the same time.
Stitch is trying to get him in that that pin combination there.
I think he's just trying to reach out. He's
there's the tag. Did he? No, he didn't get it. There he got it.
He's got a legal maneuver.
Man. Oh.
Working on the leg is Mike Goodman. As you phrase you were using earlier, the surgical precision of the detective, of the stuntman, Goodman, Mike Goodman, this guy.
Mike Goodman, PI, exactly.
I'm just screaming so much, I am getting my throat dry from this action.
Good, nobody wants to hear you anyway, Lathrop.
You'd be lost without me, buddy. Super kick! Don't you love super kicks? You need to enjoy life some more.
Yeah, that's what they tell
me. Here comes Apocalypse!
And then I get stuck next to you every week.
Apocalypse back in the ring now with Mike Goodman. I don't know if Orville saw the tag.
No! Looks like he did because he's not shuffling him out of there.
Jack Karen now! This match is just going crazy at this point.
Orville's kind of lost control of this one, Lathrop.
Which we knew was going to happen. We have six individuals of all this talent.
He had all these combustible elements in this match.
Breaking through the double suplex.
Oh, whoa.
And now they're just falling on top of the ropes. I mean, there ain't really much left for there.
Wait a minute.
Wrong person hit as Apocalypse is down.
Jack Price just super kicked Apocalypse.
Hits all neck breaker. This could be it for Mike Goodman. 2, 3.
That's it.
Here are your winners, John Kidwell and Salt and Pepper.
Apocalypse looks to be in rough shape after that super kick from Jack Price.
We have seen this miscommunication, as you like to call it, Sean Lathrop. Before.
And here comes Jack Tarrant and stitches against Jack Price. John Campbell's going to try and stop it. The former champion. And now he's going right after Mike Goodman, PI. Mike will be too quick. Apocalypse holding onto that jaw. I'm not sure if you've ever experienced a super kick before. They are terrible.
When was the last time you stepped in the ring?
Last night, actually. As we're seeing the champions here, Salt and Pepper, bringing together. They have a huge match coming up at Trick or Slam.
We've seen this before, Sean Lathrop. He blatantly kicked him in the face. You saw it.
But you know, they're going to try and bring it back together. And they're... Apocalypse! Apocalypse just striking down Jack Price.
Whoa.